folks never knew why they call it like they do. I was wondering since he gave it to down on Copper Line. Copperhead, Copper Beach, copper kettle sitting side by each, copper coil cup of Georgia Beach down on Copper Line. Half a mile down to Morgan Creek, I'm only living till the end of the week. Hercules and a hog nose snake down on Copper Line. Take me down on Copper Line.
When you think of James Taylor, you think, at least I think, of a great singer, songwriter. The man wrote some beautiful songs. But he's also, of course, a very accomplished and gifted finger-picking guitarist. For example, this song has an incredible groove. That's just so much fun to play. Let's start with the intro, and it starts with a very strange chord, and the idea is to sort of set the mood. Then it gets started. Now, I've seen some weird chords in my life, but this has to be one of the most strange things I've ever done, right? It's basically a D chord, of course, with the capo second fret, but with a G on the bottom string. Now, this might feel a bit awkward for most people. So thankfully, you can also play the chord without the thumb, like this, which probably is something I would recommend for most. Notice again the use of dynamics here. I don't play every note equally as loud. Then there's no magic if you do that. It doesn't send a shiver down my spine. I need to start loud and end the phrase softly. It needs to sort of fade away in the background. Now, the real difficulty of the song, of course, is the groove. Let's first have a listen again at James Taylor. So the thing that stands out is that catchy bass line, which is very easy to play by itself on the guitar. Of course, it ain't that easy. James Taylor is also playing the D chord while doing that bass line. And he has a very peculiar way of playing the D chord with the index finger on the top string. Yikes. And for me, this feels pretty awkward. So I'm just going to play a regular D chord. And then the middle finger is going to do the bass and head back to the D chord. So the first step would be to do this. This surely feels pretty awkward also if you're not used to it, but with a little practice, it can be done. Then the next step is to simply add one strum just with one finger, the middle finger, on the top strings. Like that. I use a bit of the fingernail as well. So that makes... That already sounds actually pretty good, right? If you can do that, simply add two notes, one on the B string, and one on the G string. Very intricate stuff. And as you can tell, the bass is done with the thumb and the rest is all middle finger. Now, if you're able to do that, then you might as well go all the way. You only need to add one thing, a hammer-on on the top string. And congratulations. This is it! It's so much fun if you're able to play that. And of course, Rome wasn't built in a day, so start in a slow tempo and finally build things up. Let's play that whole verse very slow for you. Here it is.
Take me down on copper line.
And that was the bridge, the only other part we really need to learn. The song only has basically two parts. So let's take a look at the chords. He starts with this B minor. It's not a real B minor because I don't press down with the bar, the index finger. It's easier. I only press down the A string and I want to hear that top string. It has a certain beautiful sound that we want. And these chords look familiar. We already saw some of those chords in the verse. Then down on copper line. And he ends with and congratulations. This is what you need to know in order to play the song. And of course, the challenging bit really is. It's almost addictive to play that groove. Let's see if we can play the main parts together. You can find the tabs at my Patreon site. I'm gonna play the verse and the bridge in a slow tempo. Here we go.